Given the racialized violence we have seen in our country, it is clear the civil rights movement is far from over and America is still plagued with racist ideology. But what can science say about race? What if science could help erase racism once and for all? Hey everyone, it's Natalia Reagan back at it again at DNews. First of all, it is time that we start teaching our kids as soon as they can talk, and adults for that matter, that there is no biological basis for racial classification. In terms of biology, race doesn't exist. Now that's not to say race isn't real, though it's important to understand that race is a cultural construct, that humans created this and has nothing to do with our biology. There are no distinct genetic boundaries for the groups commonly called races. Traditionally, scientists have used race to refer to a subspecies, and what determines a subspecies from a species varies among taxa. But in humans, there are no distinct genetic boundaries for the groups commonly called races, and we only have 0.1% variation within our own species versus chimpanzees, which have from 0.3 to 0.7% variation. Now, there is genetic variation within and between populations, but it is quite small. And the most amount of genetic variation found within our species isn't between those of European and African ancestry, it's between various populations within Africa. This is called the founder effect, or reduced genetic diversity in a population founded by a small number of individuals. Now, scientists refer to races as populations or ethnic groups, and many of the physical characteristics that are associated with race are due to adaptations to climate and environment. This can include skin color, height, nose shape. These slight morphological differences are called clines. They are genetic adaptations to the environment over time in a geographic area. As biological anthropologist Todd Disitel would say, it's about clines, not clades, meaning the variations between populations of our species are rather small versus being another branch in the old evolutionary family tree. There is also the idea that certain races are more susceptible to certain illnesses, such as heart disease and diabetes in African Americans. However, extensive research has shown that these illnesses are highly correlated with diet, stress, and socioeconomic standing. Thus, it's a lot more complex than just saying certain races are more likely to suffer from certain illnesses than others. Okay, so we've established that race as a scientific concept does not exist. So if race doesn't really exist, then why are people racist? Are we born to be wary of the other, or is this a learned behavior? Biological anthropologist Robert Sussman tackles the history of racism and the concept of race in his book, The Myth of Race. He stresses that racism is a learned behavior or ideology that can be avoided if parents teach their children to be open and tolerant. Sussman also discusses the history of racism, stating that the concept of human races began in the Spanish Inquisition around 1480, when the purity of blood decree was established. Those converting to Christianity needed to prove their Christian origins. Well, searching for pure blood is a ridiculous idea, considering that there has been no point in time when any population could be considered pure. This ideology, rooted in a racist political and religious agenda, continued on and was used by the Nazis to justify their goal to create an Aryan race, which led them to murder 6 million Jews and millions of others who they deemed inferior, including gypsies, homosexuals, and transgender individuals. But what if the Nazi agenda worked? Sure, we might all be speaking German, but we'd also have a population of people who might be considered pure in terms of lower genetic diversity. But low genetic diversity is usually the result of long-term inbreeding, so we'd have a population of inbreds that would also inherit a slew of genetic ailments associated with inbreeding. Yeah, so how's that for your not-so-fabulous result of genetic purity? And guess what? Genetic diversity is actually good for us. It leads to robust and healthy offspring. And who doesn't want that? Scientifically speaking, there's only one race, the human race. We're all pretty much the same. And if you want to know more about what science says about race, ethnicity, evolution, check out Trace's series on Test Tube Plus.
We also found new climates in Europe. Africa is a very different climate than Europe. Europe is a little colder, the weather is a lot different. And because of that, we had to adapt.
It's a great discussion on his new show, so I really recommend that you check it out. It's the first link in the description if you're on a mobile. Got any burning questions you want to ask us or other science topics you want us to cover? Leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.